Hello, Brother Jackson. My name is Silver Garcia, and I just want to talk a little bit about the game Night Shift. This is the game that we're working on this semester. Now, just a huge disclaimer, while this game is pretty much there in completeness level, there are still some bugs that would not allow us to continue being able to make every little bit of it function. For that reason, we weren't able to get everything to work. But more than anything, because of that, and for the purpose of this video, I will just talk about the different functions of the game, and we can go through the code just simply to learn, to see more than anything, what I have learned this semester, what I have seen this semester. But going along with that, let's dive into, first of all, some of the functions. And one I want to talk about first is the static variable versus a non-static variable. This I know is something we talked about, and how a static variable, more than anything, the idea of this one is a variable that is created within a class on the time of loading the class, versus a non-static variable which is created in the time of an object. So that would be comparing maybe to an item which is an object in the class, different to a class which we have here. A public class, and then we will have these being the variables. Something about this is also that all the memory is within these variables. A non-static is within the class. A non-static will be within the object referenced, while the static variable will only stay to the class. It's something that's really it's connected to the class, so it's not gonna change at all, regardless of that. Okay, moving on to the next part. Now this part is called arrays, array list, and enums. And the thing about these classes is that they're pretty similar. They're pretty much the same thing, which is they help store objects inside a class. Different things, maybe like a collection of items, for example. Here, if we look at the map itself, we can see that we have an array list, and it's for charm items, as we were talking about. And I have to go through all those different charm items, the collection within them, the location of them. But something that's really different about a typical array and array list is that the size of the array list can really be changeable, really moldable. That's something really nice, just a really nice function. Also something that should be noted is that in array list, you can also store primitives. That's a big difference between a regular array. It will not let you take that step into having them also in your list. Okay, one of the, also a similar thing to this, for any kind of like, anything that involves also a list of things. Another thing that we learned in class was enums. And something about this, it's really similar to the arrays, but instead enums are actually, they make up a class on their own, and they are able to kind of keep all these, all the different objects within the list in one place so that they can later be referenced by different classes. Different functions throughout. So here we have just all the actors, and they stay here, and the only thing that has to be done is just reference to those actors later on when one of the other classes wants to pull one of them out. So we talked about handling errors, and for that reason there's some things that I made the game control we made the game control exception, but then I also made the boss encounter control exception, being able to capture any errors within the boss control game, part of the game, the function. A good way to handle error in a program, in a game, it's to have the throw and catch functions, and these are really good. It simply allows you to be able to go through the function and be able to see, as it runs, if it gets, for some reason or another, if it doesn't function, it can catch the error and then be able to throw it back, be able to give some a different type of response and maybe get a message or just go through a different function that will be thrown back at the user. Something really important to understand is that, you know, in these games, when we are creating them, we also know that there's the Unicode, and that one's actually one that's related to the character's streams, and there's the byte streams, and these are non-Unicode texts. And so it's kind of really important to know which one we were supposed to use. Luckily in class, we were able to learn about the importance of, if we wanted to do something that's more international, something that can really be playable or simply work in different parts of the nation, especially now with the internet, we really needed to do something that was more Unicode, more connected. One of the things I think about when it comes to Unicode and non-Unicode is that, you know, with the character stream, it really has a bigger concept of what it's supposed to do in a program. The character stream, it just really works at being over a byte stream and being able to have that understanding of what it needs to do to help the specific encoding in the function. And that's really opposed to simply having the bytes that are being read or decoded from a character they represent. Yeah. So here's just kind of the input and out files that, you know, we're supposed to put in for the character stream. So one of the main reasons also to use character stream is that it just makes it really makes it easier for not being able to depend on the encoding and really just have that have it all stored in the Java Unicode. It just keeps it in a high international standard that allows, if this game was to ever become really good, be able to be playable for to everybody who had the opportunity to just simply put this up, be able to have the same coding and not have any other errors in them. Okay, one of the last things that we learned was being able to take a character class, be able to have a file, be able to have a file that saves it, be able to have something that we pull out. For that, we learned the importance of file paths to be able to get some certain information from a previously saved game or something that we've already done and already have it located in the system. For that, we usually create a file that gets saved with the program files. And that is something that can get saved. So let's say, for example, what we did as the team assignment, it was the existing game, and that was just something that gets pulled in from an existing game file. So it could save the game as well, and makes a document that creates code, gets saved in the game. Also, the inventory list, it just kind of, with this file path, it creates it so that there's already a list of what's within the character's reach, what's something they already created and collected, more than anything. In conclusion, I just have to say that this was one of the best class I had. It was a really great experience to be able to learn something new, be able to learn something that I've never done before. And just be able to add something to my level of knowledge. There's something obviously that I want to keep polishing and be able to keep working on. A question that my mom asked me and some other family members, they're like, so how's that game? And I'm like, does it work? Can we play it? Well, I'm going to have to be honest and say that the game is not fully functional. Not to say that we didn't work on anything or anything, because we did. We have a lot of stuff that does work. But as I said in the beginning, there are little bugs here and there that, let's just say they're fixable, I'm pretty sure, but it would just take unrealistic time at this point. And so we just decided to move forward, be able to take what we have and go with it. Sorry, I'm really popular today, I guess. Just to say my experience in the class was great, but sometimes with team assignments you have situations like this where it's hard to really coordinate with your team, be able to take it and learn what you can get from them. There was times where I noticed that I would be working on something for hours. Sometimes I didn't even sleep just to try to work on certain assignments that we had as a team, just to do the whole team assignment by myself. And then some codes got deleted. And that just kind of made it really frustrating. It made it really, it was kind of like a demoralizing, I would say, just to come to class and realize that everything you worked on that night was deleted. Just kind of didn't make you want to keep going. That's really my biggest complaint. Regardless of which, I really like my partner. We had a good time. We learned a lot, and while we weren't able to have a fully functional game, this is really something, an experience that I wanna continue learning upon in the future. Be able to take my time, go through this that we have, that I created during class, and be able to simply see what I did, be able to expand on it, and be able to try to maybe even fix this so it does become fully functional in the future. I just want to say that I really enjoyed my time in this class, and if in the future I'm able to take another class from you, Brother Jackson, I hope I do. But thank you for everything you've taught us, and for this opportunity to be able to be enrolled in your class for the winter semester. All right, thank you. Bye.